Dr. Kim Hammond from Falls Road Animal Hospital is here to answer your pet questions. Joining us is Bandit. What a cutie pie.
This is Bandit. Look at this dog very carefully. This is a Havamalt.
I'm looking.
This is a Havamalt. This is Havanese and Maltese cross. And, you know, they're coming out with all these new gourmet dogs.
Yeah.
Good. Yeah. Yeah.
He's a good combination.
Yeah.
I'm
yeah.
liking him.
Havamalt. Have a shake.
Okay. All right. How about some questions?
All right.
Since the temperatures have been falling, my cockatoo won't eat for days at a time. What should I do to get him to eat?
You know, this is actually really serious. And just in general, birds tend to hide their symptoms until they're really, really sick. So in this case, you know, it's probably not the storms. You need to probably come in. But I would move the cockatoo away from a window if it was there. That's kind of an important consideration. But I think it's probably not related to the weather and the storms, and you should probably come into a veterinary hospital. Now, the other thing is this. There are only a few exotics hospitals. Not every veterinarian treats birds, so you have to look around. If you need the name of one, call Falls Road, and they can recommend someone to you in your area.
All right.
Okay.
My 7-month-old lab mix sheds a lot. Is this unusual, and should I do anything?
Yeah, it's kind of unusual at that age to shed a lot, but they do shed. Some dogs shed, you know, 6-7 times a year. So you brush like crazy. That's about the only thing you can do. It's almost like trying to clean rocks out of your garden. You take them all out, and there's more.
Well, those dogs in particular, they're hairy. Those hairy dogs.
Yeah, better than a Dalmatian, which is black and white. So whatever furniture you have is ruined.
Right. Okay. I've been feeding a feral cat for years and have been recently considering making her a pet. Should I, and what steps should I take if I do?
Well, first of all, be very, very conscious of the fact that we have rabies in the area. We really have rabies, and some of these cats can have something called friendly rabies. You wouldn't even know that they have rabies.
So there are no signs?
Very difficult signs initially, very difficult. So you have to be very cognizant of that. But you have to capture it, you have to catch it, and take it to a veterinarian and go from there.
Okay.
Yep.
Any other advice for folks who are dealing with the flooding right now and
you know,
their
it's
pets?
Really, it's really tough. It's really tough there. You know, dogs that are normally housebroken are pooping and peeing in the house. I mean, it's really a disaster. But we'll get through it in a couple of days, and the rain is really good for the earth. You know, we need that rain.
Yeah. Okay. Yep. Thank you. All appreciate your time, Dr. Kim.